1 Charlie 5, traffic Foxtrot Echo Sierra 00 Tree, taking off runway, Tree 6 straight out departure.
Relief 3,500.
All right. All right. No, I didn't try to put thermals in here or anything. I'm actually a glider pilot, but just searching for thermals. Should not be trying to go fast. Should actually, when you're in a thermal, it should be around the stall speed, just above it. But I turned off that sound on the thing. I just don't like to hear it. Usually, thermals will be underneath a cloud. So, and this is actually where I learned how to fly. Where I learned how to fly first, I flew gliders first. But I want to see if I can get a thermal. I didn't really try to put any in there. I forgot. I didn't try to put any in there. The last time I found some right mix of some clouds right there. Actually, a cloud is a thermal. But that's why it looks so puffy up on top. It's air going up. But there, now we're starting to. Probably should have turned into one, maybe. I don't know. Maybe it might have been just on the edge of a thermal. Actually, when you're in a thermal, you should just be right above the stall speed. I mean, because otherwise you're just going to fly right through the darn thing. But, I mean, that's just in real life how to do it. But, I don't know how real life this is. The last time I found some right next to a cloud. I don't know if I put them in there here or not. I mean, I don't know, maybe. I don't know. I don't remember if I did. Either that or if it's just from the flight simulator. Now, when you're in sync, you want to get out of it, you know, but... I mean, you want to fly fast to get out of it, but you're in sync. But you'll sync faster, but you'll get out of it quicker. That's the object of it. Yeah, this is... Okay, no... Okay. When you're in it, you want to turn steeper. No, it doesn't seem to be, Yeah, usually if you're in a thermal, you should only be about just... Man, this is pretty fast. 55 miles an hour in a thermal, yeah. It should be on about 35, 40. But in real life... But this thing will probably stall out. And when you lose the lift, you should... Open the bank, and then when increase the lift, sharpen up. But now that does seems like a small thermal with that. It's actually just it's all you do is a bunch of turns, but the tow plane is not realistic at all. It's too it's too sensitive. When you're out of lift, you should like reduce the bank angle. When you're in it, you steepen it up. But yeah, this is good. You just want to be above the stall. But actually, the glider that I flew is I flew like 5 or 6 different kinds, but the high performance glider, the real one, like had like actually one you can get like 42 lift, 42 lift ratio. Now that's really good, but yeah, it's just really small thermal. If that. But this one I think is like 28 they said, or 3 or more. And actually, in a blue sky, that's where the sink is. But ideally, you want to be underneath a cloud. I mean, I don't know how realistic this is, but this is the first time I've flown this. Just I wanted to try this out because I flew to Clow International Airport, and that's where I learned how to fly. And it's the first thing I learned how to fly are gliders. But, oh. But the stall characteristics of the high-performance gliders, they hardly stall. I mean, you stall them and they don't stall. Just a little buffet and that's it. But this thing, there's a definite stall in it. But because the high-performance ones, the wings are shaped, you know, so you don't get a nose-down pitch. Because you're always going to be next to a stall if you're thermaling. So that just a little buffet. And then that's it. But this thing here, there's a definite stall. You can feel it. But, I don't know. I'm not really finding a decent thermal here. So we get down to 2,000. Yeah, I forgot. I don't think I really put any in there. I don't know. Maybe I screwed that up. But I don't know. Oh, we're losing altitude here. Man, I gotta find the thermal, or otherwise I gotta go back. We are definitely losing altitude here. Come on, cloud. Well, I think I'm going to have to go back if I don't get a thermal here. Yeah, I guess I'm going to have to go back. I don't have a choice. Yeah, I turned that sound off here. See, in a regular glider, that wouldn't happen. I mean, in a high-performance one, you wouldn't stall out like that. It would just be a buffet. It's a little bit too much, but my opinion. On the two, and they say never fly downwind of the airport. But you know, I can't seem to find myself because this is all backwards. I don't think there's much here. Getting really low. I hope that's not the airport, man. We'll never make it. No, I don't think I'm going to make it back to the airport. I'm gonna end up in these trees here. I got a motor, don't I? Why, I have a motor. They must have paid for this too. Thank you. I got one without a motor. Has no motor.
One Charlie 5 traffic Foxtrot Echo Sierra 002 taking off runway 36, departing straight out.
There we got a motor. All right, so we are now at Clough International Airport. This is where I learned how to fly gliders at. My first introduction to aviation was flying gliders. Reason being, I thought it would be cheaper than a powered aircraft because it, you know, don't have an engine. But actually, it was more expensive because you need a tow pilot to tow you up. But anyway, this is I just flew here the other day. This is in a new glider. And it's a little hard, my procedure for getting a tilt plane to go. I'm not sure. I got to go out of virtual reality to activate the tilt plane. You know, I hope everything works all right here. And it has an electric motor. Last time I couldn't find any lift. Didn't know how to work the motor. So anyway, I gotta go to out of virtual reality.
On the roll.
Yeah, you're supposed to stay down low to the ground so you don't pull the tow plane off the ground with the tail. Man, this thing really shoots up there though. I was like thinking you can try to box the wake in this thing, but I'm having trouble just because boxing a wake would be, I'll try it. This is like low and then you go out this way and you rise up. I'm not gonna try it. Actually, it's a procedure that you got to do to get your license. But this thing, it's just hard to fly it behind the airplane, so I'm not going to try that. Best time to go soaring is like about 2 o'clock in the afternoon. Too bad you can't see the rope.
Relief 3,500.
Yeah, no, I think I still forgot to put thermals in here. Well, maybe not. There's one right here, maybe. So when you're searching for thermals, you don't want to be that fast. You just want to be above the stall speed. Well, I mean, when you're inside a thermal. But, because otherwise you'd just go right through the thing. And what's the point? But, and actually, blue sky would be sink. And actually, the cloud is a thermal. Yeah, but they're just little. Maybe I didn't put any in here. Well, how can I when, I don't know, I'm not, too happy right now. I'm not in a thermal. That's what the thermal, you're supposed to steepen your turn when you go into the thermal and lessen your turn when you come out of it. But I can't seem to... Thing is that that thing which you can find the thermals at doesn't work in virtual reality. I'm just going to turn around. Before I lose too much altitude. I don't know, I was flying before, I was in a pretty good thermal, but... I got ballast too, I should get rid of them. Should have put the gear up also. Yeah, why is it the thermal? I was flying it earlier and I wasn't recording it, and it was I was in a thermal, but I quit, and now I can't get in one. Let's turn on the motor. Well, I thought we were in some lip there, but guess not. Seriously, land right here in the grass. They don't anymore, though, here. Not bad. All right. So now I've flown a glider at Clow International Airport. It's my first flight ever in a flight simulator. Because last night, or the other day, I just flew here from Rhinelander, Wisconsin, from my house. And I just landed here and I seen this glider. And I'm like, wow, that would be cool. But I was flying earlier and I was getting... I was in the lift. But I couldn't find any today. But this glider is alright. I think maybe I will try to yeah, actually, you sit down in there, lay down, like. That's pretty cool. Never had a motor, though. Or I never used ballast either. But, pretty cool. I must say. I bought the Paywar version of it. But the flying with the tow rope, that's not that realistic at all. I mean, it's hard to follow the airplane. It's touchy, but I suppose that's with all flight simulator stuff. That very touchy, but and I guess it flies all right. I mean, I think there's almost too much lift in it, but it flies good. I like it. I really enjoyed it, actually. But I went and turned that this variometer down, because that's just ridiculous. Listen to that all the time. That would drive that other people. Have that on, I'm like, geez, please just turn it off. But yeah, I like it. It's all right. So this is my first flight from Clow International Airport in a glider, in the flight simulator. So anyway, hope to make many more flights in the glider. I'm gonna try to find a different place to soar, but I just wanted to at least get one flight here. So anyway, thanks for watching. I hope you liked the video, and like and subscribe to my channel. Alright, thanks. I'll catch you later. Okay, bye.